One out, one on. Eric Hinsky flying to the track his first time up, and he laces this one foul off the right side. Sox don't hold Myers on at first as Millar stands in behind him. And there's a strike to Hinsky. Pedro Martinez has now thrown 73 pitches as he works here with one out in the fifth inning. Red Sox in charge here today on top, 9-0. And Hinsky fouls it back. Sox will be welcoming the Detroit Tigers beginning tomorrow night. And what is a brief two-game series against Detroit. Jeremy Bonderman will go against John Burkett in the first game, then game two. On Tuesday night, it is Derek Lowe against Mike Moroth, former Red Sox farmhand. Swing and a miss. Strikeout number 7 for Pedro. Well, over the last couple of innings, that changeup has been unbelievable for Pedro Martinez. 2,000 innings in Pedro's major league career now. And does it on the changeup to pick up the strikeout, seems fitting. 7 strikeouts today, 2 down here in the fifth inning. Myers had led off with a single, still standing at first. And here's Orlando Hudson, who lifts it in the air to left, playable for Ramirez. And that'll do it. Toronto leaves a man halfway through this one. Red Sox on top, 9-0.
We can't reverse the curse. We can rewind the week on Red Sox Rewind. Hey, tune in Ness's new 30-minute magazine show that reviews the Red Sox week that was. Red Sox Rewind offers a week's worth of player profiles and interviews, game highlights, locker room reaction, team news, notes, and more. After an exciting week in Red Sox Nation, unwind with Rewind on Nesson.
Explorer 4 doors are available with a no-charge power moonroof and a no-charge third-row seat. Get Explorer with $3,000 cash back or 0% for 60 months. Plus, for a limited time, you'll save over $1,400 in no-charge options. Or lease Explorer for only $299 a month. This special program ends July 31st. Ford authorized clearance only at your New England Ford dealer.
Back at Fenway, it is 9-0. Red Sox on top as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. And the Red Sox are kind enough to send you a cake along here to celebrate. Well, we lost some of it.
And all that was this.
The 2000th telecast for Jerry Remy today. And we have more of some of the Remy follies over the years. Goodness.
That's some analyzing there, isn't it?
That was terrific. Kevin Millar to lead it off here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Millar with a home run in the second inning, his 16th of the year.
What are we going to do with this cake, Don?
I think we should probably eat it.
You better get yours now so we can start spreading it around, give it to someone down in Press Row. Maybe the radio guys would like some.
No, I think they would. You notice they've been eyeing it on the other side already. In fact, Trubiano was yelling at me. He wants his piece right now. We caught you. Now he's going to pretend that he's doing the game. The 2-1 will miss to Millar. 3-1 the count. Cut your cake.
That is a knife. Grounded foul outside of third. That is a big league knife.
He'll just take a small piece. Any plates?
Adam doing fine work as usual.
Yeah.
Millar strikes out to begin the inning. The first strikeout for Tanya and Sturts. And there's one away in the inning. Let's check out the Heineken What's on Tap for the Red Sox. Mentioned the Tigers will be here for the next two. 6:30 our start time on Ness. And then the Devil Rays are in for two Wednesday and Thursday. 6:30 on Wednesday. The special day game on Thursday will be on the air at 12:30. All the action right here on Ness. Here's Trot Nixon, one for two. Nixon tripling his last time up and driving in two runs. Part of this 9-0 Red Sox lead in the last half of the fifth inning. Sox with three home runs today. Millar in the second inning. Nomar Garciaparra in the third. And then Manny Ramirez in the fourth. Game between the Red Sox and the Blue Jays. And they have split the first 16 of the season, each winning eight. Orlando Hudson at second base picks up this grounder by Nixon and throws him out, two down. I would like to welcome today's visitors to the Dunkin' Dugout out there in the bleachers in right field. Dunkin' Donuts, proud to host area youth and charity organizations at every Red Sox home game. I'd also like to thank them for dropping off refreshments to the booth. Down, here's Jason Varitek, who's 0 for 2. He's grounded out twice in the game. So he's getting up there at 93 miles per hour that time. Bullpen early today after just 2 2/3 innings. And they have action again in their bullpen. It starts working here in the fifth inning with two down.
Now the Blue Jays go from Fenway to New York for a couple of games. That's Corey Thurman loosening up. Saw him in that series up in Toronto, just recently called up by the Blue Jays. Ouch. Having a tough afternoon for Greg Myers behind home plate. He's got nailed a couple of times.
Well, Jason Varitek has been hitting very well. And if you go back to June 25th, 403. June 25th, but to batting overall at 299. A little professional courtesy here as Angel Hernandez walked out to the mound, came back, gave Greg Myers some time to get himself together after being nicked on that pitch. Foul tip. And a 3-2. Swing and a miss. Went up top to get him. Second strikeout for Sturts. Red Sox down in order for the first time today, but on top 9-0.
It's Toyota's Summer Fun Sales Event. You can save thousands with 0% APR financing on 2003 Tundra pickups. Or you could get combined savings of up to $2,165 on most Tundra models or up to $1,070 on most Tacomas. Don't miss these hot summer deals. See your New England Toyota dealer now. The Summer Fun sales event ends August 4th.
Best deals on built Ford tough trucks. F-Series has been the number one selling truck in America for 26 years running. Ford Super Duty has more pulling power than any truck on the planet. And F-150 was named the highest ranked full-size pickup in initial quality by J.D. Power. Get your F-150 or Super Duty with zero financing or up to $3,000 cash back at Ford Authorized Clearance. Get to your New England Ford dealer now.
Back at Fenway, all Red Sox 9-0 in this game. Stay tuned after the game for W.B. Mason's Extra Innings, New England's Red Sox postgame show with extra highlights, extra interviews, and extra analysis hosted by Bob Rogers and a new lineup of studio analysts. After the last inning, the action is just beginning.
Well, Pedro Martinez, 7 strikeouts through the first 5 innings. And he has given up just 2 hits, one to Howie Clark back in the first inning and one to Greg Myers last inning. Well, he's into the sixth. He's thrown 76 pitches, and he deals with 9-1-2 in the Toronto order. Chris Woodward leading off, foul tipping one into the mitt of Jason Varitek. Woodward is one of the strikeout victims today. And quickly down 0-2. Second time today that he has struck out. 8th strikeout for Pedro Martinez.
Well, even with the long layoff, you don't see the rust on Pedro Martinez today. As a matter of fact, he looks well rested and very strong.
One down, 4 in a row now retired by Pedro. Back up to the top of the order for Howie Clark, who has managed to get on base twice today. He singled back in the first inning and then reached on an error in the third inning. Was erased as he tried to steal second base, was caught, and gunned down by Jason Varitek back in the third. Pedro Martinez has struck out 6 of the last 8 batters. Here to right field, back goes Nix, and he started to his right, now goes back. This will take him just shy of the track for out number 2. He was busy early with 5 putouts, but his first one since the third.
Well, keep cool as the summer heats up. Sports your summer threads, get your Major League Baseball authentic caps, jerseys, t-shirts, and more at RedSox.com. The RedSox.com shop for all things baseball.
So 2 down here in the 6th inning. Frank Catalanato standing in, 0-for-2. He's flied to right and struck out swinging. Sends this one to right center field. Back goes Damon, full bore, onto the track, into the triangle to rescue that one. A 1-2-3 6th inning, some help from the outfield. But Pedro Martinez, splendid today and on top 9-0.
Drinks before lunch?
Water's fine for me.
Water for me, too, but with lemon, please.
I'll have a Sam Adams, please.
Hmm. Make that two Sam Adams.
Oh, I'll have a Sam also. Me four.
Nice. Never miss an opportunity to enjoy a tasty Samuel Adams lager, especially when it's on someone else's tab. Samuel Adams, always a good decision.
Starting with me, everything in this place is mean and miserable.
Is that a tear in your eye, Private? Do you want your mommy? Are you going to cry?
I'll kick the tradition and chivalry out of you.
I suggest you shut your mouth.
I can't hear you.
Nothing is over until we decide it is.
Just one more thing. Don't ever make me mad.
Sweet dreams, ladies. Cradle up, right now. Ha!
Back at Fenway, it's been all Boston today. Red Sox on top 9-0 as we get ready for the bottom of the sixth inning. This inning is the Foxwoods Fantasy inning, and today's contestant is Greg O'Connell of Boston. If the Red Sox hit a home run this inning, Greg will be a winner of dinner for two and a free night stay at Foxwoods Resort Casino. For your chance to win, visit boston.com/Nesson. Toronto using their third pitcher of the day, Corey Thurman, into the game.
Corey Thurman called up a June 12th from Syracuse. First time up this year with the Blue Jays. Spent all of last year at Toronto. He was a Rule 5 pickup. One of those appearances against the Red Sox. He's only made two on the season.
The first face, Damian Jackson, who's been very productive from the number 9 spot, vying for his third hit of the day, and Wells makes the running catch to rob him of his third hit of the day, and Jackson retired for the first time.
Center fielder, number 18.
Let's check in with Eric Fried. Eric?
Well, fellas, after last night's exciting game, the thrilling come-from-behind win, the question I got asked more often than any other here today was, how did you find Molly? Truthfully, that's what it was. So it's really a craze that's starting to sweep the nation here in Red Sox Nation as Wally's friends and family have come from all over. Jill from Westboro is here with her family. And what do we have here today, Jill?
We have a Wally family reunion here. We have the old-time Wally, All-Star Wally, regular Wally, and who are you? Oh, Father's Day Wally.
Father's Day Wally. They have them up here. They have a beautiful view of the ballpark, first row of the monster seats. And Jerry, I think you're discounting the fact that Molly got up to the booth last night just in time for the rally. I don't know if Molly had an impact on that victory last night, but we have to think about it.
I don't know where Molly's going today.
He's brought up a very solid point. If you think about it, Molly positioned next to Wally's when it all started. We don't know where Molly is now.
when the blood rushed back to Wally's head after the game, I saw he and Molly going out. So
they've already cut their ties, apparently. That is quite a collection that they have amassed.
Put a lot of work into those chairs.
And here to right field off the bat of Damon Hudson, ducking back to make the catch for out number two.
Well, the Red Sox now provide a free shuttle bus operated by Paul Revere to Fenway Park from Northeastern University. Service is provided for every Red Sox home game. Clean, comfortable, handicapped, accessible buses depart every 10 minutes, beginning 90 minutes before game time. And buses return to the station at Northeastern up to 1 hour after the game. For more information, visit RedSox.com.
Two down for Bill Miller. 0-for-3. Miller is fouled out, struck out, and grounded out. Now, six in a row, retired by Toronto pitching. Tanyan Sturts working to begin that stretch. Sturts gave up 3 runs during his time out there today. The home run by Manny Ramirez, a 2-run shot back in the 4th inning. Wasden gave up 6, Sturts giving up 3, and now Thurman, the third pitcher of the day. Thurman's just 24 years of age, and in his second season in the big leagues last year, the Blue Jays appeared in 43 games and was 2-3 for Toronto, made one start, but otherwise all of his action coming from the Toronto bullpen. Started off in the Royals organization as Kansas City made him their 4th round pick back in 1998. Rule 5 guy taken by Toronto. A lot of teams taking chances on the Rule 5 draft. Where sometimes you notice another player, another organization, sweep him up as this is grounded outside of first. And really there's very little risk. I mean, you take him, you take a chance. If he makes your big league club, then you keep him. If not, then he perhaps goes back to the other club. But it seems like a system that has worked for a lot of different teams.
A lot of teams seem to be taking those guys. They spend 1 year at the big league level, then the next year they start out at the minor league level to... They really don't pitch that much generally in that first year and continue that development. You're right, Don, though. It seems like there's a lot more of that recently.
Fouled off. And it is, to be honest, a cheaper route as well. I mean, financially, if you're looking to fill out your team and you think you can do it with somebody else's players in some cases, then it is not as costly as getting a guy who is more high-priced. Taking a chance is certainly cheaper. And a lot of teams have really done quite well with it. Full count to Bill Miller. Miller on the ground this time to Woodward, who has trouble with it. And Miller will reach.
Now Woodward has had some difficulty out there defensively this season. This will probably be his 17th error of the season at shortstop. Went to the backhand.
Shortstop.
It looked like he just picked that glove up a little bit too soon. Ball slicing off the bat of the left-handed hitter. Just really didn't get down low enough to make that play.
It is indeed an error committed by Chris Woodward, the Toronto Blue Jays' first error of the day. Here's Nomar, who is 2-for-3 today. A three-run home run and an RBI double. Two hits, four runs batted in for Garcia Parra. And he pops this up, foul off third. Hinsky darting back towards the stands and diving in is the shortstop, Woodward. And he does not come away with it as he leaned in a couple of rows trying to get that one. So Omar's got that batting average up to 324. He began the day at 322. And fifth overall in the American League in average. Catalanato, but that'll drift back into the seats. Corey Thurman, who did begin his career with the Kansas City Royals organization, the highest he got in the Royals organization before the Rule 5 draft, was AAA Omaha in 2001. McMyer's coming back in the same general direction that he was in the first inning, but no chance this time. Toronto took the first two games of this four-game series. Red Sox in dramatic fashion. Coming from behind to win last night's game. And here today on top 9-0 as they continue to bat in the bottom of the sixth inning. The Red Sox, including Nomar Garciaparra, did some running last night. Nomar with two stolen bases. Red Sox had four thefts in the game, matching their season high, which was also against Toronto. They set that April 10th at Sky Dome. Evens up now at 2-2 to Garciaparra. This has been more along the lines of the offensive production the Red Sox were used to in the first couple of months of the season. Count down to Nomar. Red Sox batted 300 as a team through the end of June, but they've hit just 253 in 16 July contests. Knocking them down to 292 as a club, it's still the best in the major leagues. at first. Nomar swinging and popping it up. From third comes Hinsky down the line towards the mound. Makes the adjustment and makes the catch to end the inning. We played six from Fenway. 9-0 Red Sox. R sends it deep.
At Moss Eye Discount, there are so many tools and tops to choose from, you won't know where to start. Tools for the do-it-yourself or tools for industrial use. Tools for the most demanding jobs, all at Moss Eye's deep discount prices. The walls are filled with hand tools and accessories like Black & Decker saw blades, drill bits, and router bits. Moss Eye Discount also has the area's best selection of tarps in sizes from 5x7 to 50x100. In Newport, Trailside Discount Outlet on Moosehead Trail next to Subway has the same great selection. For quality tools, tarps, and ropes at deep discount prices, Moss Eye Discount Outlet in Bangor and Trailside Discount Outlet in Newport.
Downey's Toyota, the exclusive home of Logan the Service Dog, and we're also Maine's number one selling Toyota dealer, both new and used. With over 500 import and domestic vehicles in stock, we have a car, truck, SUV, or van for everyone, and we will beat any advertised price on a new Toyota in Maine. For quality, selection, and service, and the lowest price, Downey's Toyota, across from the new Super Walmart on Wilson Street in Brewer. Call us at 1-800-TOYOTAS. Take Logan's advice, check anywhere you wish first, but check us last. Right, Logan?
I try as best I can to stop underage drinking, but I can't do it alone. We bring these kids in and all they get is a slap on the wrist and then they're at it again. We need help from everyone, including parents and judges. Otherwise, we're all part of the problem. And we become just another tool to help them drink.
Since 1975, the enforcement of minimum drinking age laws has saved over 17,000 lives. Say nothing, do nothing, stop nothing.
Boston Red Sox baseball in Nesson is brought to you by Dodge and by Samuel Adams Boston Lager. Well, it's the top of the seventh inning back at Fenway Park. And a fan has run onto the field from the right field corner, so we'll have a delay here for a moment. And security will be dealing with him. He's in a conundrum right now as he ran into a pile of security. So they will take care of him out in right center field. In the meantime, we'll tell you about Pedro Martinez, who today has been outstanding. 8 strikeouts over the first 6 innings. He's not given up a run and just 2 hits for Pedro on the afternoon as he waits for the security to take this gentleman off the field.
Well, each time the Red Sox catch a run of stealing on Nesson this season, you can enter them to win a LoJack stolen vehicle recovery system for your car or truck at boston.com/Nesson. Simply enter the date, opponent, and the run of the Red Sox caught stealing at boston.com/Nesson, and you'll be entered in the LoJack caught stealing sweepstakes.
Here is Vernon Wells to lead it off. He has struck out twice today, both times swinging, once in the first and once in the fourth inning. He's on top 7-3 in the seventh inning against Cleveland today.
Oakland getting beat again 4-1 in the fifth inning. Minnesota doing a job on Oakland.
The Twins 6.5 games back of the Kansas City Royals to begin the day. As the Royals started off so well, then went through that lull, but they are back now. The Royals with a 6.5 game lead over the Twins in the Central. White Sox with fading. This is down the line. Deep third. Bill Miller tried to corral it, but drops it. And on at first base is Vernon Wells. Third time in the game the Blue Jays have had the lead man on.
Well, we showed you the sequence in the first at-bat for Delgado. Let's take it his second at-bat with Pedro Martinez. And it's pretty simple here. 3 straight changeups from Pedro to get Delgado.
And Vernon Wells aboard at first on a base hit. An infield hit for Wells, just the third hit of the day for the Blue Jays. Wells joins Greg Myers and Howie Clark, who each have hits today off Pedro. And in the dirt, and Varitek able to grab it on a hop, 1-1. Well, Delgado 0-for-2 today, fly to the track and right in the first inning, then struck out in the fourth. For 13 in the series. This is up the middle. Jackson with an empty plate and Nomar for one on to first, double play. Nicely done on the 4-6-3 double play, two down.
Well, Damian Jackson having himself a pretty nice day. He's got a couple of hits in the ball game. A lot of range shown here going to his right, a nice underhand flip. See, Nomar first makes himself a first baseman there to get the force out, and then spins around to make the throw to first base to get the double play. Make sure that one at second, and then completes the double play.
Two down for Greg Myers, who singled his last time up. He's 1-for-2, chops it softly towards Jackson, handles it, and throws to first. Couple of people there, but Millar handles it. Over there was Pedro, just in case. Seventh inning stretch time from Fenway, as the Red Sox have the 9-0 advantage, and we will keep it right here at Fenway Park. Seventh inning stretch on this Sunday. We'll keep it here for God Bless America.
Okay, folks, let's get this party started. Call Seattle. Get McGregor on the phone.
Calling him now.
Morning.
Good morning.
This is Scott McGregor. I'll be out of the office all day. Please leave a message.
That's not like McGregor.
McGregor's not there?
Great.
Excuse me, there's a Mr. McGregor here to see you.
Southwest Airlines last-minute fares. If you're paying more than $149 nonstop to Orlando or Tampa Bay, you're paying too much.
You are now free to move about the country.
Right. Got it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, that's great news.
I appreciate it.
Goodbye. Well, I've got some fantastic news.
I'm out of here.
No, it was Geico. I just saved myself a bunch of money on my car insurance.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Behind him is a 400-square-foot deluxe bachelor with a partial view. In front of him is a junior executive semi-private with no view. But right now, life is perfect. On the open road, in complete control of an Acura RSX. One of Car and Driver's 10 best.
To Fenway Park as we get set for the bottom of the seventh inning. We are honored to be joined here today by 108-year-old Mary Jo Ray from Westmoreland, New Hampshire. This is her first time ever at Fenway Park. She's been a lifelong, and it's a long and full life, lifelong Red Sox fan, and she has a special treat for us right now here as we head to the bottom of the seventh inning. Mary Jo, go ahead.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I never get back. Let me root for the whole. shame, for it's 1, 2, 3 strike of road and the old ball game.
Mary Jo Ray! That is our Citizens Bank, not your typical fan.
I guess so. Thank you very much, Eric. Nice job.
108?
Yes.
Still belting out the songs, too.
Yes. Here's Manny Ramirez to lead it off, and he fouls it off. 1-2 the count. And Pedro Martinez may be done. He's shook some hands in between innings and certainly appears to be headed off to the clubhouse. With a fine effort today, over 7 innings of work, and departing with a 9-0 lead as the Red Sox bullpen is busy. As this one, Carr fouled by Ramirez back into the seats. There is Brandon Lyon in the Red Sox bullpen. So Pedro going 7 innings today, giving up just 3 Toronto hits, no runs. He did not walk anybody, and he struck out 8. Inside to Manny, and it evens up at 2-2. Ramirez grounded out to third base in the first inning. He walked and scored in the third and then hit a 2-run home run off Tanyon Sturts in the fourth inning. All part of this 9-0 Red Sox lead as they bat in the bottom of the seventh. The Blue Jays after the game will travel to New York and play a brief 2-game series against the Yankees. The Red Sox remain home against the Detroit Tigers. Well, he strikes out to begin things in the bottom of the seventh inning.
Well, get the Globe's award-winning sports coverage every day. Call 1-800-984-5335 for 50% off home delivery. The Boston Globe, your world unfolding daily.
Away, David Ortiz 0-for-2 with a walk, and he has scored a run. Toronto's used 3 pitchers today. John Wasdin went 2 2/3. And Sturts went 2 1/3. And now Thurman on for his second inning of relief. He's not yet given up a Boston hit. Red Sox had a base runner against him last inning when Miller reached on an error. Ortiz swinging for the fences. And Reichert up in the bullpen. Further action for Toronto. Mentioned the power that Ortiz displayed this month. What has been an awesome attack for him. 7 home runs. He had 4 home runs in a 48-hour period in New York against the Yankees to begin that 4-game series. And still some time in this month. Foul back off to the left, and it evens up at 2-2.
Yeah, the amazing thing, Don, when you look at Pedro's performance today after spending, you know, quite a bit of time off, almost about a week, no walks. Did not have a walk in this game today against the Blue Jays.
You mentioned that you could sort of anticipate maybe a little control issue early with the strength, with him having a lot of time off, but there was none. Ortiz swings and it's held on to by Myers. Awkwardly, but he does, and there's 2 outs in the inning, back-to-back K's for Corey Thurman.
First baseman, number 15.
Thurman has done a great job since being in this game. Really ties up the Ortiz there with the fastball right in on the hands.
So 2 down, here's Kevin Millar. Hit a home run in the second inning. Since then, has struck out twice. The home run was his 16th of the year, and the RBI is 63rd. I would think that this is your 2000th game that the scorecard would certainly be a keepsake.
Yes, it might be a collector's item. You never know. Check it out on ArenaReport.com. And there is some cake on it, too, so that's the added little bonus.
I noticed that on the bottom. The
yeah, a little
cake
chocolate
stain.
Chocolate cake stain.
So if you do get a scorecard from Jerry Remy that does not have any stains on it or cake, then you know it is fraudulent. It's not the real thing. The real thing has cake all over it. Lifted in the air to shallow right center. Bobby Kilty coming in, shading his eyes from the sun, still able to make the catch. A 1-2-3 seventh inning for Corey Thurman. We've played seven. Boston on top, 9-0.
Introducing new sweet and moist scones from Dunkin' Donuts. Just the thing to break away from traditional tastes. Of all the thrilling lines that Nissan brings you, this may be our most interesting. The bottom line at the Nissan National Sales Event. Drive the Murano, intelligently equipped at $28,199. Or the rugged Xterra with 0.9 financing and $1,500 cash back. And lease a Pathfinder for only $319 per month. But hurry, these Nissans are going fast, and that's the bottom line.
Feeling lucky? In July, Nesson will designate one inning during each Red Sox game as the Foxwoods Fantasy Inning. If the Red Sox hit a home run during that inning, you and a guest could win a night stay at New England's premier entertainment destination, Foxwoods Resort Casino. Foxwoods, the wonder of it all. With six unique casinos, 24 restaurants, five lounges, and headline entertainment all year round. Hurry to enter, or your chance to win could be going, going, gone.
Right now, the only thing between you and pure happiness is a straw. Introducing the refreshing, thirst-quenching Dunkin' Donuts Lemonade Coulada.
Back at Fenway, the Red Sox on top, 9-0. And shutout pitching today from Pedro Martinez over his seven innings of work, not giving up any runs today. And Pedro was outstanding. He gave up just three hits all day and ended up with a total of eight strikeouts. And Chris Woodward twice, Vernon Wells twice, and he struck out the side in order in the fourth inning. Catalanato, Wells, and Delgado all down by way of the K in the fourth. And today, also receiving some run support as he leaves after his seven innings of work and should pick up win number seven of the season. So he turns things over as Red Sox have some defensive changes. First, Doug Mirabelli taking over in behind the dish for Jason Varitek. And Gabe Kapler in left field for Manny Ramirez. Red Sox have a new pitcher also, Brandon Lyon. Welcomed into the game by a line drive by Bobby Kilty, right at Johnny Damon for out number one.
Brandon Lyon making his 42nd appearance for the Red Sox.
Third baseman.
His last coming just a week ago, Sunday in Detroit, two-thirds of an inning in that ball game.
1-1 for Eric Hinsky. He's flying to the track and right and struck out swinging as he fouls it off the left side. Further action in their bullpen as Corey Thurman's done a very nice job over two innings of relief. Record still up in their bullpen. The right-hander was up last inning. Well, Brandon Lyon was such an important part of the Red Sox first couple of months. He was their closer. And what did he reel off? Nine in a row at 1.9 for nine. This is grounded softly right side. Damian Jackson picks it up and throws out Eric Hinsky. Two down.
Stay tuned after the game for W.B. Mason's Extra Innings, New England's Red Sox post-game show with extra highlights, extra interviews, and extra analysis, hosted by Bob Rogers and a new lineup of studio analysts. After the last inning, the action's just beginning.
Yeah.
Two down, and here's Orlando Hudson. He's 0 for 2. He's flied out twice. Quickly grounds it to the shortstop, Garcia Parra. He throws him out. It's a 1-2-3 inning for Brandon Lyon on just 7 pitches. We're through 7.5, 9-0 Boston.
Do you know you're driving your competition to drop the prices?
I've been warning them and warning them that furniture shopping will never be the same.
I know, but now you've got them in panic mode.
Does that make me a bad person?
No, if you can deliver something like this for $7.99. Ooh, is this a... Ooh, vibration.
Dual massage.
Ooh, console.
Built in.
No way, is there?
Check it out.
Oh, oh, heaven. Oh, oh, this is good. Hmm.
Behind him is a 400-square-foot deluxe bachelor with a partial view. In front of him is a junior executive semi-private with no view. But right now, life is perfect. On the open road, in complete control of an Acura RSX. One of Car and Driver's 10 best.
And you, Wyatt, how'd you make your first billion?
Oil and cattle. Let's call it offshore banking.
Ah! And you, Jones, we're all curious. How'd you make your first billion?
Me? Oh, Pepsi.
You invented Pepsi.
Oh, no, I just drank one.
Want your first billion? Enter Pepsi's Play for a Billion sweepstakes. 1,000 winners compete for a guaranteed million on live TV. And one may even win 1 billion.
You guys got a foosball table?
Check specially marked Pepsi products.
Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway Park as we get ready for the last of the eighth inning. It's been all Boston today as we take a look at the game summary. The Red Sox on top 9-0. Nomar Garcia Parra with a home run, a double, and 4 runs batted in. Manny with a 2-run home run. Damian Jackson from the number 9 spot contributing today, 2-for-3 with a double, and he has scored a run. John Wasdin was chased after just 2 2/3, giving up 6 runs to the Red Sox, including 2 home runs. And Pedro, 7 shutout innings today. Some defensive changes. Jason Wirth is in the game in right field for Toronto. The right fielder, Bobby Kilty, going from right field to first base. And Carlos Delgado getting the rest of the afternoon off. The new Toronto pitcher is Dan Reichert.
Dan Reichert called up on July the 10th. He's made a couple of appearances, pitching 1 inning so far for the Blue Jays. Of course, we remember him with Kansas City. Last year, he pitched in 30 games with the Royals, had 6 starts, had a record of 3-5.
This is the bottom third of the Red Sox order. Trotnickson, Jason Varitek, and Damian Jackson. Off the end of the bat, cue down the third baseline. Hinsky has no play. Trying to barehand it was his only opportunity and couldn't do it cleanly, and Nixon is on.
Trotnickson couldn't have rolled the ball down that third of the baseline any better than that. Hinsky, a do-or-die play with the bare hand, can't come up with it, and Nixon picks up his second hit of the day.
Here's Doug Mirabelli for the first time today after he took over last inning for Jason Varitek. Mirabelli at 245, 3 homers and 11 runs batted in. Jason Varitek today been 0 for 3, 2 groundouts and a strikeout. As Dan Reichert able to get that one by Mirabelli. Record from Monterey, California. Spending time in Tampa Bay last year. Prior to that, 4 seasons with the Kansas City Royals. Originally a first-round pick of the Royals, 7th overall in 1997.
When did he go to Tampa Bay?
He was there last season for a brief stint.
Toward the end of the year?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I remember him in Kansas City, obviously.
He was in Kansas City 99, 2000, 2001, and again to begin last year. He was 3-5 at the Royals last year, 30 appearances. picked up on waivers by the Devil Rays. The University of Pacific, which is in Stockton, California. That was one of your stops.
Yes, Stockton, California. Used to be a ball for the Angels organization.
And it's softly towards Woodward at short to second for one. Kind of a strange toss, but they're still able to complete the double play as both Nixon and Mirabelli are erased, two down. Two-way, and that'll bring up Damian Jackson. Is that the California League then, too? I know it is.
Yes,
now.
It was, yeah.
I believe now they are affiliated with Milwaukee, or they were the last couple of years.
It used to be Stockton, Bakersfield, Visalia.
Palm Springs part of that?
Fresno. No, Palm Springs is not in it, no.
Damian Jackson fractured his bat, so he'll go get a new one here as he fouled that last pitch off. Some new stuff. Oh,
along with Sherry.
Yeah. Along with Sherry Remy. Sherry! This is a very recent stuff, I think, right there.
Yeah, that was today.
Deep into the archives for that.
You know, it's been fun, you know, 2,000 games, whatever it is, but it's always fun to come to work when you enjoy the people you work with, and I've been very fortunate with Ned and Bob Kurtz and, of course, Sean and yourself to come here every day and, you know, enjoy it, have fun. And that makes it all worth it. I love the job. It's a great job, and it's also fun to work with people you enjoy.
A lot of games. I mean, 2,000, does it seem like 2,000?
I don't know, Don. You know, just wake up, do a game.
It's the same thing every day.
Same thing every day, but a different, you know, different action on the field, which makes it a lot of fun.
1-2 to Jackson is chopped up over the mound. Hudson has it eat him up. Chopped up over everything with an in to center field. Nasty bouncer there. Jackson is aboard again.
Hey, you take hits any way you can get them. And it looked like that ball might have hit right at the lip of the grass where the grass meets the dirt in the infield and kicked up over the head of Orlando Hudson. Right there. That's a nice feeling for a hitter. You know, you think you might have a ground out. Instead, you get that bad hop. Pick up a base hit, your third of the afternoon. Not bad.
It's a great surprise. Two down and Jackson at first. Here's Johnny Damon, who has two hits in the game. I was surprised to find out that you felt like you struggled your first season and that
hated it.
You really didn't enjoy it.
I hated it. I had no clue what I was doing.
This is chopped at first, and there to make the play is Kilty. He'll run to the bag for the final out of the inning. Red Sox strand a man. We've played eight. They're on top, 9-0.
These everyday low fares to your favorite vacation destinations start at just $49.
You are now free to move about the country.
No matter how great the problems, skill and hard work make the difference. Hamill, Waxler, Allen, and Collins, personal injury law.
For extra convenience, extra value, and extra service, stop at Extra Mart. When you're on the go, you need a little extra. Fuel up on Extra Mart's Deli Joe sandwiches, Brew Boy coffee, and more. For your car, Extramart offers the brands you know at competitive prices.
Pick up irresistibly delicious, extra nutritious Nesquik in a wide variety of flavors and sizes. Nesquik, milk made fun.
With over 150 locations throughout New England, be smart. Shop Extramart.
Boston Red Sox baseball on NESN is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by New England Ford dealers, by Aflac, and by the Bona Joint Center, Caritas St. Elizabeth, so you don't have to be an all-star to be treated like one. We're to the top of the ninth inning, and there's a Jerry Remy fan club in Colorado, apparently. We saw Iowa earlier. Trying to really branch out.
Might be website visitors.
That's probably the case.
Now, look at that. That's a smart-looking shirt, isn't it?
It really is, yes. The one is in there for a strike, 0-2 to Chris Woodward, who leads it off. Woodward struck out in the third and again in the sixth, both times against Pedro Martinez. And I think what goes on in the open that never sees air is probably more enjoyable than what actually comes out in the open sometimes.
Iowa.
Ground ball by the mound. Jackson moving in and throws wildly into the Boston dugout. They will award second base to Chris Woodward. Oh, got away from Damian Jackson, who's charged with an error.
And this copyrighted telecast, presented by the authority of the Boston Red Sox, may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. In addition, the accounts and description of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Boston Red Sox. Now, that really the only blemish today on the mark of Damian Jackson. He's had a terrific day. Picks up an error, though, on that throw to first base.
So Woodward stands at second base, nobody out. Howie Clark, 1-for-3 in the game. And he sends a foul back into the seats. Clark had a base hit, the first batter of the game. Back in the first inning, he singled into center field. Sox with their second error of the day. Nomar had committed an error earlier in the game back in the third inning on a ball that Howie Clark grounded to him. Casey Fossum up in the pen. Red Sox have made only 13 errors coming into the game over their last 31 games, beginning on June 14th. And since June 14th, the Red Sox have been charged with more than one error. Only one time, June 19th in Chicago, they made two errors. So today, the first two error game in better than a month. But it's not been costly. Red Sox on top, 9-0. This is chopped left side. To his left goes Miller, bobbles it. The throw will not be in time. And they charge Miller with an error.
A tough start here for the ninth inning. Back-to-back errors, one by Damian Jackson, by Bill Miller now, and the Blue Jays have a couple of base runners. It's like Bill Miller took his eye off her for just a second. He was looking towards second base, and by the time he picked it up, too late to get Howie Clark down at first.
Two on, nobody out for Frank Catalanato. He's 0-for-3. You got to figure there's another 1,000 left in you, maybe 2,000. What do you think? Double up what you've done already?
Depends how long college goes, you know. Wouldn't mind a couple of thousand more.
Fouled off the left side. It's 1-1. And the 2,000, that's part of the national stuff, too, right? They compiled the national number.
Yeah, I guess not. I don't know. Somebody at NESN, I said, you know, got this thing together. I had no clue about it, but I think they did count in the Fox games and I think spring training games maybe. There was a time we were doing in with NESN almost every spring training game for a number of years. By the time you get to the season, you were blown out. And then Lyon worked to 1-2-3-8. He's not had much help defensively here in the night. This is Lyon to left field by Catalanato. Over goes Kapler to make the catch for the first out of the night.
As you know what that's like in spring training, you were down here this year and you had to file a report every single day. I mean, you're like a road warrior.
Yeah.
You're in the car every day going to some ballpark. Not even the players go to every game.
No. But we did.
I'll tell you, the funniest year was that replacement year. We had to do those games.
Oh, good.
The only good about them was they got over like 2 hours.
Did you know any of the players?
Oh, they couldn't have been friendlier. I mean, they all wanted to get on TV. And, of course, when they settled the strike, then we went back down and we did the regular game for, I think, 2 weeks. But it felt like we were there forever.
But you were.
I mean, we're the only people doing replacement games. I mean, MSG was pulling out, you know, we're doing a big Yankee Red Sox replacement game. It was unbelievable.
No one will miss to Vernon Wells. He's 1-for-3 today. Did they at least play the whole game, or was it like a spring training game where they made all the switches after the third inning?
They played most of the game, yeah.
So it was a little bit easier time in that regard. Opposite field base hit for Vernon Wells. And they will stop Chris Woodward at third in Toronto as the base is loaded with one out here in the ninth.
Vernon Wells extends his hitting streak today to 8 games with a 2-for-4 day. Started off slowly, a couple of strikeouts against Pedro. But now back-to-back base hits.
Number 13, Jason Worth.
So base is loaded, one out. And it brings up Jason Worth for the first time today. He takes over in Carlos Delgado's spot. 222, 2 homers and 9 runs batted in for Worth.
I remember one day that we had one of those replacement games. We had a split squad. One was in Minnesota, which is close to us. The other one's in Clearwater, right? So Kennedy's the manager, and he's pitching this local guy, Mike Carista, up in Clearwater. So I went to him. I said, "Can you do me a favor and move him to the Minnesota game so we don't have to travel as far?" He did.
He did.
So we went over and we covered in Fort Myers. We'd have to make that trip to Clearwater. So, you know, TV pretty much ran the show.
He's probably wondering, "Wait a minute, I'm supposed to start in Clearwater."
Yeah, we had the big local guy going, so we wanted to have him on, but we didn't feel like driving to Clearwater.
He had no idea that the reason he wasn't going there was because Jerry Remy made the switch. Didn't feel like driving to Clearwater. In there for strike 2-1.
They're pulling into Fort Lauderdale, and MSG's pulling out. They're pulling all their equipment out, and we're adding this game to our schedule because it was a Yankee Red Sox game. What an essence, brighter moments.
I'm sure you didn't say anything and just went all about your business and didn't mention the fact that you were adding games.
I went through a whole month just shaking my head.
Two to Jason Worth. Missing away. It's a full count now. Base is loaded for Toronto with one out. This is the first time in the game that the Blue Jays have had a runner reach second base. But the base is loaded with one out here in the ninth now. Got him. Brandon Lyon's first strikeout is good for out number 2 in the ninth.
Pretty good zip on that fastball from Brandon Lyon. Had no chance. That ball was by him.
The catcher, number 28, Greg Lyon.
Fastball up at 93 miles an hour for Lyon.
So two away, bases loaded. Here's Greg Myers, the catcher, 1-for-3, singled off Pedro in the fifth inning. One of only 3 hits off Martinez.
And if you're just joining us today, Pedro Martinez, 7 innings, 3 hits, no runs. He didn't walk anybody, and he struck out 8. Very nice performance today by Martinez in line for his 7th win of the year. And falling behind 2-0 to Greg Myers. On a close pitch, Angel Hernandez calling it ball 2. Lined into right field, a base hit. This will score some runs. Woodward in from third base. It'll only be 1 as the shortstop gets in on the base hit to right field for Greg Myers. And the Blue Jays are on the board. It's down 9-1.
One base at a time, down by the 8 runs now for the Blue Jays. No reason to take any chances. Greg Myers, he's had a 2-hit day. Picks up his 38th RBI of the season. Looks like he's coming out of the game. Is that Reed Johnson pinch running? I believe it is.
It is Reed Johnson. We'll run at first base for Greg Myers.
Number 37, Reed Johnson. The hitter, number 24, first baseman, Bobby Kilty.
Here's Bobby Kilty. The start of the game in right field, made a great catch out in right field earlier. And now the first baseman softly down the first baseline. Well placed. Millar throws and not in time as Lyon could not get to the bag. A run scores. As in from third comes Howie Clark with the second Toronto run.
Almost like a drag bunt, a swinging drag bunt by Bobby Kilty. Once he gets it by the pitcher, nobody at first base, and nobody had a chance to make a play. That's one where Millar really almost has to stay home and hope that his pitcher or second baseman can make that play.
Well, Dave Wallace talking things over with Brandon Lyon, who has 2 outs here in the ninth. 2 runs have come in. 2 errors in behind him this inning, which is a key point. After enjoying a 1-2-3 eighth inning, and now just trying to shut the door on the Jays here in the ninth. Nerikinski 0-for-3 from his number 7 spot in the Toronto Blue Jays order. Fly to the track in right in the second, struck out in the 5th, and grounded out to second base in the 8th. This one down the right field line towards the corner, a fair ball. Jumps up into the seats, a ground rule double. And that will score 2 runs. And it's now 9-4. So Vernon Wells comes in, so does... Well, at second, Reed Johnson. And right now, Toronto back within 5, it's 9-4.
Hinsky goes right down the right field line. One big bounce into the stands for the ground rule double. He picks up a couple of RBI to give him 34 on the season. And the Blue Jays are not going easy here in the ninth inning.
Orlando Hudson, the ninth man to bat. He's 0-for-3 in the game. And he takes ball 1.
Now you've gotten the bullpen, Embry and Kim throwing. The last thing you expected to have happen in this game.
You're ahead 9-0 coming into the ninth, and a chance to give the rest of the bullpen the day off. They are up and warming now. 1-0, big swing and a miss from Hudson. $34,221 on hand here at Fenway Park today for the 4th and final game between the Red Sox and the Blue Jays. Chop foul down the first baseline, and it's 1-2. One ball, 2 strikes, 2 outs here in the top half of the ninth inning. Toronto with 2 in scoring position. Inside, it evens up at 2-2. Piece of him. We'll hop around a bit here with the count still 2-2. Brandon Lyon's been operating around the 93 mile per hour range with his fastball. We'll finish off the Jays here and gain a split in this four game series. Toronto winning the first two games. Lined on one hop to first. Millar picks it up, runs to the bag, and the ball game is over. The Red Sox have indeed gained a split in this four-game series with the Toronto Blue Jays. Toronto coming up with four in the ninth. Red Sox with a couple of errors in the inning, and the Jays leave two on. But the Red Sox today win 9-4 behind strong pitching from Pedro Martinez. And Brandon Lyon works the last two innings.
Well, the Foxwoods chance play of the game, the home run by Nomar Garciaparra. This back in the third inning, a three-run home run in a five-run inning for the Red Sox. Garciaparra's 14th of the season. The Foxwoods chance play of the game.
Well, the Yankees were 7-4 winners, so the Red Sox remain four games back. They keep pace with New York. Pedro Martinez, the winner, 7-2. John Wasden takes the loss, 0-1. Again, the final, Boston 9, Toronto 4. Now it's time for the WB Mason's Extra Innings with Bob Rogers and Bob Tewksbury.
Donnie, thanks very much. The offense comes to life today, but Pedro Martinez, I think, really was a story, Tukes, because he had the long layoff, had not pitched since last Saturday, but he was brilliant.
Well, he did, and that's why I don't think it's a big deal when Pedro has that much time off. He only had two strikeouts the first three innings. The middle three innings, he struck out six and was just got better as the game went on.
A lot of fly ball outs early.
He had six fly balls to right field.
And Trout Nixon made a great catch. Good day for the Red Sox offense as the Red Sox salvage the split of the four-game series with the Toronto Blue Jays. We're coming back with WB Mason's Extra Innings right after this.